summer your work on this reauthorization. As one of our armed services, the men and women of the Coast Guard deserve our continued support. The chairman and ranking members' leadership have been instrumental in drafting a bipartisan bill that ensures the Coast Guard has the resources to accomplish its mission. And I appreciate Chairman DeFazio's work on the Pay Our Coast Guard Parity Act, which I understand will be included in this bill. The government should never shut down, but if it does, we have to make sure the personnel protecting our national security interests, all of them, are paid. From drug interdiction to defense readiness to protecting America's geostrategic interests in the Arctic, the Coast Guard is an instrumental partner in the Department of Defense, or to the Department of Defense, in service to our national defense. However, as this committee is aware, the Coast Guard is often asked to do too much with too few resources. I've heard repeatedly in this committee room that the Department of Defense missions that the Coast Guard supports, which are important, could be taking resources away from its equally important non-defense missions. We cannot let Coast Guard performance in drug interdiction, search and rescue, or maritime safety suffer. The challenge is to ensure that this collaboration between the Department of Defense and the Coast Guard remains equitable, responsive, and sustainable over the long term. The Coast Guard has an important role to play with the Department of Defense, but they should not be undercompensated for the missions they are asked to perform. As Commandant Schultz recently told this committee, just 3% of the Coast Guard's total budget comes from defense and has not changed since 9/11. And while the U.S. Coast Guard estimates that their service provides about $1 billion in support to the Department of Defense, reimbursement from the DOD is capped at about $340 million a year. That's why I'm so pleased my amendment to examine the U.S. Coast Guard Department of Defense partnership has been accepted as part of the manager's amendment. My provision is straightforward. It would require the GAO to issue a report on the resources the Coast Guard is dedicating towards the defense readiness mission, the resources that have been reimbursed to the Coast Guard from the Department of Defense, and how the Coast Guard's non-defense missions are being impacted due to the annual levels of reimbursement provided by the Department of Defense. With this new report, this committee can better understand the operational challenges facing the Coast Guard, and our future Coast Guard authorizations will be better for it. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I yield back.
Thank the gentleman.